Hey everyone, my name is Peter McCarron. I'm a senior technical marketing engineer here at LaunchDarkly. And today we're going to be talking about how you can use LaunchDarkly to control database migrations in a Kubernetes environment. Before we dive into the code, I thought I'd give a little bit of background about what we're going to cover in this demo. So what you see on your screen here is a basic architecture of what we're going to be working with. Now, most people when they use LaunchDarkly are usually familiar with front-end feature flags. This is typically something when you're using one of our client-side SDKs, so something like a React. We're going to use that in this demo, but that's not going to be the primary focus. One of the big advantages of LaunchDarkly is that we also support server-side flags. So for instance, we offer a JavaScript SDK, which we'll be using in our node environment here to be able to talk to our backends momentarily. This application that we're going to be running is a simple to-do list application. As you can see, we have an Nginx server. It's talking to a React frontend. It's communicating with an Express server, and it's communicating with a Postgres. And what we're going to do is we're going to introduce a MongoDB database as well. And we're going to use feature flags to be able to control how information is flowing between the two of them and show you a couple other cool tricks that you can do with LaunchDarkly. So with that, we'll go ahead and jump into the code. So to get us started, let's take a look at our application and talk a little bit about what's going on here. So as we mentioned earlier, this is a simple to-do application where I type in my tasks and it connects to a database to store that information where I can then see it on my list here. So as you can see, I queued up a couple of tasks already where we have Postgres, task one, task two, task three. Let's take a look at our Kubernetes environment and our Postgres database just to show you that this is not all smoke and mirrors. So if we run a kubectl-get pods, you'll notice that we have a series of applications that are running in our Kubernetes cluster. We have an API, we have some front-end applications, as well as an Nginx and a Postgres pod. If we exec into our Postgres pod, what we can do is we can log into Postgres and we can take a look at our database to see if we're retrieving that information. We're going to connect to our demo database. As you can see, we have a to-dos table. And then if we do a command just to see what we have running here, you'll notice we have Postgres task one, two, and three. So let's see what happens when we remove those tasks from our to-do list. We clear out some of these, and we flip back over to our terminal screen. You'll notice that we now have Postgres and task three. So clearly we're communicating with our Postgres database, but let's show what it looks like in LaunchDarkly when we want to switch over to MongoDB. So here's our LaunchDarkly environment. As you can see, we have a couple different flags that are currently set to off. We have one for enabling the login functionality, which we're going to demo here in a second and show you what that's going to do. And then we have one for enabling access to our new database. So when we serve that to true, we should be communicating over with our Mongo database. To show the difference, here in our Mongo database, we've queued up a couple of tasks already that we should see when we switch over. So we have task one, two, and three, as well as MongoDB, which will be reflected in our to-do list when we retrieve those features. So let's go ahead and flip on this and see what happens when we refresh our screen on our migration application, or on our demo. All right, interesting. So we're only seeing the same tasks that we saw previously, and there actually is a good reason for that. One of the great things about LaunchDarkly is we have the ability to set what are called prerequisites. So if we open up my flag here, you'll notice that in my database, I have a couple of different prerequisites. Typically on the operations side, I'm not going to want to just enable a new database for everybody until I've done some testing first. I want to have certain users take a look at it. I want to do some measurements, make sure my latency doesn't get affected. So I want to control who has access to that environment. And so what you see here is we have a prerequisite flag set that we're saying, if this login functionality flag that we had on the previous screen is not set in serving our dev feature, then we shouldn't be able to serve this flag. So no matter what, we're always going to serve false. We also have a targeting rule in here, which we're going to show here in a second. So let's go back out to our feature flag and we can enable our testing for our functionality. This is a front-end flag. So really what this is going to do is it's just allowing us to be able to have the login bar. It's just detecting that that's working properly. Otherwise we'd be getting a 404 page on our to-do application. Now let's go ahead and log in with that dev user that we showed. So I'm going to use myself as a dev user and we'll refresh and we'll see if our tasks change. We'll log in, refresh our screen here. And now, as you can see, we have tasks one, two, and three that we had from MongoDB. And then again, just to show that this is actually communicating with our backend application, we can remove some of these things. Go back out here, refresh Docker data. And as you can see, we have no query fields anymore. Now, if we go back to our demo application and let's say I log in as Alex, you'll notice that we're seeing the Postgres again. The idea here is that we're not just using a Boolean flag, right? We're controlling how we can enable access to our new database, which would allow us to do some different testing. Let's walk back through some of the flags and take a look at some of the different rules that we could put in place. So here we are again in our LaunchDarkly dashboard. One of the things that we said before is that we would have the ability to set what's called a prerequisite. So the way I set this up is that I had my login feature, which essentially says it should be either serving dev or public. Let's flip over to our code and take a look at that to see where those flags are actually being called. So here we are in our code base. This is our to-do page. It's just a React application, like I said. It's one of the components that's getting passed in. We have a series of different things in here, but the main thing that we want to look at is that we have this fetch that's basically pinging the API to make sure that things are working properly. And essentially what this is telling us to do is that if you can't reach out to the API where our Express server is, you should just serve a bad connection, which will give us a 404 page. But the other logic that I added in here was using a flag to be able to control the ability to be able to test our new databases. So what I did down here is I've created it to where I have this login flag, which is what we saw on LaunchDarkly. And I'm saying that I either want to have it be public or dev. If I don't get either one of those, then there's a problem and I really should set my error to true because something is going on. Someone's being able to access this that shouldn't have access to the environment that they're currently in. And that's just gonna allow us to serve that task. So that's step one. That was the piece that we talked about of having our client-side flags in here to enable access to a database. And the reason we did that is because if we're going to do something very sensitive like a database migration, we probably don't just want to turn it on and hope that the front end is set up and equipped for it. That might cause some error messages or some other places. Looking back at our LaunchDarkly environment, you'll see we have this enable access to a new database flag. Within this flag, what we're doing is, again, we have that prerequisite that we're saying we want to make sure that it's in dev mode in order for us to be able to serve it. So from a user perspective, if I were to flip that flag off, I'm not going to see anything different. Again, if I go back here and I turn this flag off, maybe because I want to do some additional testing on my front end and I refresh the screen, I'm still going to see the same thing because we've set the logic in such a way that we can still serve the default database. We only want to enable the new database for users who are then in a dev and testing mode. So if we enable this back on, what we could do is we could just say, we're going to enable this for everybody. So we could have not put this targeting rule in here. So we'll actually remove this user. We'll save this, make sure that the default rule is set to true. And we'll refresh our screen here. And you notice we don't have any tasks because we cleared out all of our Mongo tasks. But if I were to put this in MongoDB, we have not logged in. Now we have MongoDB showing up, go back into this environment, we refresh, we're getting our documents here. So this shows that if we were happy with the performance of this, we could enable it for everybody. The other thing that we could do, which is really fascinating, is let's say we wanted to do some testing on this. Let's say we wanted to have multiple people try this and see what happens when they log into different sessions. We could actually do what's called a percentage rollout. And so a percentage rollout would say that 50% of the users are going to see our true value, 50% are going to see our false value. So we'd initiate a new session every single time. So we got a 50-50 shot. Let's say that I want to set it to 50-50, and we'll open up a new private tab and see if this works for us. So now we're going to open up a new private tab. And as you can see, we just happened to get the Postgres as one. That's a great way if you want to have this controlled rollout. One of the things that we'll be able to do in the future with our new release insights is that let's say we did this, we could actually test the latency against those and see what the performance of moving to our new database was. If it's good, we could flip it on. If it's bad, we could flip it off. So that's a way that we can quickly get started being able to control how we actually migrate databases. We did this all in a Kubernetes environment. Real quick, let's take a look at the code just in case you're curious about like how does this actually work. So here's our index.js. Essentially what we did is we are trying to assess a value every single time that we are hitting our API route. So we have this post route. What we're looking for is that API flag. And we're basically saying that if it's true, what we should do is we should do the logic query for our MongoDB. And if it was false, we should do our standard Postgres query. The nice thing here is that this gives me the capability to be able to remove this in the future. So if I do my testing, I'm happy with my new database, I could just rip it out and I could just move all entirely over to the new database. If the new database isn't working for me, I could just rip that out and I could be able to fall back to the default values of the things that I know that are working. This is great, especially in a Kubernetes environment, because we're able to make these changes independently in different pods. Remember, the beauty of a microservice environment is everything's interconnected, but it's also independent. So we're able to make these changes independently in these different pods, and our users are all happy, developers and operators being able to control things with feature flags. Thank you so much for watching this demo, and have a great day.